Welcome to Buxton's High Edge Raceway for the first round of the Northern and Midland Drivers' Championship.
Take a look, Scott.
Cars emerging from the pits for heat one. I'm talking to Phil Hagel in the pits. He assured me that the aerofoil was designed during the nightmare. Cars now on the rolling lap around the wet, slippery Buxton Raceway. Phil Hagen pushed wide by 391 Andy Smith. 188 Lisa Harter already pulling off. Heath Chambers, the first red top, is 391. Andy Smith hitches up with 69 Paul Lomax. 488 Andy Turner joins the trio in the fence. And at the front, Elliot Smith, 161. And number 50, Graham Bird up there. The leading red, 250, Keith Chambers. Keith Chambers now chasing around the pit's bend after 303, Jim Bamford. Elliot Smith now through in the lead, and in second is 161, Mark Eaton. In third, number 50, Graham Bird. As 303 is spun out on the new bend. Okay, lead car, 392. spun out, all pushed wide as 161. Mark Eaton now takes up the lead position. In third, number 50, Graham Bird, coming up on the back bumper of 392, Elliot Smith. And Elliot pays the fence a visit. Graham Bird takes the opportunity to go through on the inside. So 161, number 50, and 250 now in third. 392 in fourth, and 354, Richard Ainsworth in fifth. Further back, 172, Steve Hodgson moving up, along with 454, Phil Hay. So Keith Chambers now challenging number 50, Graham Bird. Chambers on the inside, and through up to second place. So race order now, number 161, Mark Eaton, away in the lead. In second, 250, and in third, number 50. But it's 161, Mark Eaton now, rounding the pit's bend in lead position. Number 50 under pressure now from Richard Ainsworth. Ainsworth on the back bumper of number 50, and 50's heads wide, bought by a back marker. So looks like 354, Richard Ainsworth moving up one place. 161, 250. Through now, down to the pits bend, with 250 closing in all the time. 488 is pushed aside, 161 goes through, but on the inside now, 250, Keith Chambers takes up the lead. 250, Keith Chambers now down the home straight, into the pits bend in lead position. 161, Mark Eaton in second. So Keith Chambers now breaking away, first place in the lead. 161 in second, looking back for 354. Then it's number 50, Steve Hodgson now, 172. And then number 7, Nigel Parker. Keith Chambers through in the lead. 161, Mark Eaton. 354, Richard Ainsworth now moving up. On the way, 488, Andy Turner, edged wide on the wet tarmac. 350 now, well in the lead. 161, pushed wide. 354, sneaks through on the inside. So Richard Ainsworth now, 354, up to second place. Mark Eaton still chasing in third. 250 with almost one straight clear lead. Goes round the top bend. Now's the pits bend. Passing back markers as he goes. 108 clips the fence. 250 now picks up the last lap ball. Goes through to the pits bend. 354 surely too far away enough to do anything about this one. So 250 now coming down the back straight. Comes round the new bend for the last time. Onto the checkered flag. Heat 1 winner, 250, Keith Chambers. In second, 354, Richard Ainsworth. 161, Mark Eaton in third. Now looking for fourth, it's 172, Steve Hodgson. Keith Chambers once more proving that on tarmac he's the man to beat. Number 5, Trevor Bedford, wobbling around the new bend with a flat tyre. Group 1 winner from Shepshed, number 250, Keith Chambers. And on the second attempt now, cars away for heat two. Number five, Trevor Bedford in trouble and over the car goes, over and over. And on top of 391 Andy Smith, car comes to rest at an incredible angle. So number five on his roof. 115 clips the Amco and the race is brought under caution by the yellow flags. And across track number 5, Trevor Bedford suspended in mid-air. Marshall's pulling Trevor out of the upturned car. Takes a look at the car at that peculiar angle. How did he get in that position? So the car goes back onto its wheels. Somewhat crumpled there, the foil. Otherwise the car looks reasonably okay. 391 also has the crumpled there, the foil. And the restart for heat two. Trevor Bedford has not rejoined, but 391 Andy Smith is out and racing again. The 7, George Fletcher clips the fence. Lead cars go through once again, the lead Red Sox 250. Lead car though, number 50, Wayne Bird. In second, number 108, 250, 391, 180. And the Smith has been pushed wide, so 180 now followed by 354, Richard Ainsworth. Lead car, number 50, in second, 250. 108, 180, 354, 391. 464, Ian Sturt linking up with 116, Kevin Clare. Those cars safely away, down the home straight. Looking for lead car, number 50 goes through. 250, Keith Chambers in second. 180, Ray Witts now in third with Richard Ainsworth moving up into fourth. Lead car, number 50, Rainbird. 250, Keith Chambers in second. In third, 180, with 354, Richard Ainsworth in fourth. Ray Witts goes through, Richard Ainsworth. Further back, 108, 454, 272, 303. Number 71, Richard Park, lines with 408. Phil Clegg, who is one of Rob Moore's mechanics. But in the lead, number 50, followed by 250, Keith Chambers. Both cars down the home straight and into the pits bend. Round goes number 50, Graham Bird, as 108, Dave Wadsworth hits the fence. Lead car, number 50, Graham Bird, 250. Following on in second. Graham Bird now away, 3-4 cars length in the lead. Now comes down the back straight. Closing down on back markers, 250, closing in, no. In third, 180, Ray Witts, and in fourth, 354, Richard Ainsworth. A long gap, now down back to second, 454, Phil Hague, with 272, in fifth. And 250 now is taking up the lead. 250, Keith Chambers, first position, number 50, Graham Bird, in second. Keith Chambers round the pits bend and down the back straight. So heat one winner is now heat two elect winner, with number 50 chasing them. 180 is up in third on the back bumper of second place man, number 50. Rainbird under pressure now from superstar 180 Ray Witts. And Witts can't get through this time. Keith Chambers, however, through in the lead, 50 in second, 180 in third, Richard Ainsworth in fourth, and 180 comes through on the inside of number 50, Graham Bird being balked by 108 Dave Wadsworth. So Ray Witts, 180 moves up one place, goes through the new bend, followed by number 50, then 354. 354 though is through on the inside of Graham Bird, so Richard Ainsworth now through to third place. The way in the lead now, number 250, Keith Chambers, 180 gaining all the time. But number 250, Keith Chambers now starts his last lap. In goes the 180 bumper. But 250, Keith Chambers holding on. In fact, 180's lost some space there. 2.50, Key Chambers comes through towards the checkered flag. Heat 1 winner now picks up Heat 2 as well. 2.50, Keith Chambers. 1.80, Ray Witts in second. 3.54 in third. And Rainbird picks up fourth. Oh, 1.16, Kevin Clare under pressure from 1.69. 116 spins round on the new bend and collects two cars. Have to put them out of the placings. So red flags are out, bringing Heat 2 to an end. So there's only one car on maximum points so far in the Northern and Midland Drivers' Championship. It's Keith Chambers. Heat 2 winner, number 2.50, Keith Chambers. Cars were in their pits, it's rained again, so the track now well and truly soaked. The cars away on the rolling lap though for Heat 3. They're round by 77 George Fletcher and 392 Elliot Smith. And 180's pushed wide straight away by 409 Rob Moore. Which regains the lost ground. And up front, 392, Elliot Smith has the lead. .188, Lisa Harter spins round, flex 115, Alan Etheridge and 35, Ryan Andrew. Lead car, 392, Elliot Smith in second, 161, Mark Eaton. Then 464, 105 and 21. And the yellow caution flag's out again. Incident on track. And number 71 is on his roof. behind him, number 77, George Fletcher, also gold. The 71 car now back on four wheels. George Fletcher. Well, it's a bit heavier than they thought. So with extra muscle power, over goes the 77 car. George Fletcher racing a 2.5 Ford engine. Most cars, of course, from the 3.5 Rovers. So the restart in single file with Elliott Smith leading them away. 161, 464, 21, 69. So we're looking for lead car down track, and 161 Mark Eaton emerges in first place. Ash Calvary now through to second. In third, there's a fight for third, 392. The rest of the pack go through. Lead car, Mark Eaton in second, 21, 464, 69, 172. 488, Andy Turner. Passes 172. And then number 70, Chris Flynn. 172 has regained his place. So 161, 21. Now 69, forcing through for third place. Ian Sturt not giving up easily. Paul Omax, however, through to third. 172, Steve Hodgson now in fourth. 161, 21, 69, push wide by Steve Hodgson. So 172, Steve Hodgson now up to third. Ian Sturt, we're on the inside of 69. Sturt regains fourth, 69 in fifth, 488 in sixth. 161 in the lead, 21 in second, 172, 69. Danny Turner goes through. So Turner now following Lomax down the home straight. Sturt in with a bumper. On 6-1, 21, 172, 69. Lead car, 161, Mark Eaton. Way down the home straight. Alan Etheridge goes wide and into the fence. Very hard into the Armco barrier. And one, number 21's been passed, 69, Paul Lomax is moving up. Looking for lead car, 161, Mark Eaton away in the lead. And Marshall running round to look at 115 car. And out comes the red flag. Ian Sturk into the top bend fence. Went in very hard. Cars are slowed down, seeing the red flag. The race has been stopped for 115 Alan Etheridge. He's in fact knocked out as he went backwards into the Armco barrier. helped out of his car. And Alan looks okay. Checkup in the ambulance required. The results will stand as the race was stopped. Off goes 71. So heat 3 winner, number 161, Mark Eaton. Track for the final. Points scored here today will be added to those scored tomorrow at Hennisford, totaled up, and the winner will be the new Northern and Midland Drivers' Champion. Bill Haig explaining how it should be done to 150 Hans Kiddingham. Away in the rolling lap. The man with most to lose is 180 Ray Witts, the current Northern and Midland Drivers' Champion. Elliot Smith and 108 Dave Wadsworth leads them round. One on five, Alan Etheridge, out of the ambulance and back into the Amco. He's carried on going this time. 4:54, Phil Haig in with a bumper. This flame pushed towards the barrier. Phil Haig moves up on the inside of 172, Steve Hodgson. Hodgson holds on though. 391 car is going round without an aerofoil now. Lomax pushed out to the barrier. The 391 car without his aerofoil. Lomax again hits the barrier on the far side. 250 goes through, 180 and 392. Ray Witts chasing Keith Chambers. 161 in the lead, 15 second, 250, 180. Through the lead goes 161, Mark Eaton. Mark already collected a lot of points today as 115 pulls up. So, Heat 3 winner is now leading the final. But it's 180 Ray Witts now through into second. 250 in third. 391 Amy Smith shedding a wheel guard. 161 under pressure from 180 and 250, and 250's moving up past 2 at 1, so it's now 250. Keith Chambers in the lead. Round the new bend, 180 in second, 391 and 161 and number 50. So Keith Chambers led every race he's entered so far. 250 Keith Chambers in the lead. 180 Ray Witts tracking in second. And coming down the back straight, number 35, Brian Andrews smoking, and that is the flash of an engine exploding. Brian bails out of the car. So looking back for lead car, 250 Keith Chambers, 180 Ray Witts in second. So 250 Keith Chambers, way in the lead, but he's got 180 Ray Witts chasing him down the back straight. 250, 180, 161 in second, chased by fellow blue top number 50, Graham Bird. 172 and 354. So the battle's on for third and fourth. 161, number 50, and 172, 354. Lead car 250. 180 Ray Witts right on his tail. Both cars down the home straight. 250 in the lead, 180 trailing him every move. Cars now down the back straight. 250's opened up some daylight. Ray Witts in second. Small gap now back to third. 161 Mark Eaton. 172 Steve Hodgson. 50 with 354. Passing both cars. Richard Ainsworth through up to third place. 172 in fourth. Number 50 in fifth. Ainsworth round the pits bend. Down the back straight, holding on to third place. Richard Ainsworth has also a healthy points tally from this meeting so far. Now in goes Lisa Harter, chased by Rob Moore. Moore goes through on the inside. Hans Kirimar, now 464, Ian Stern, battling round the pits bend. And Hans Kirimar's pushed sideways into the Amco barrier. That's Hans's race run. We're in the lead, 250, chased by 180. 250's been spun round, so 180 goes through into the lead. Last lap now, 180 Ray Witts takes the lead. Now no challenger, 180 Ray Witts, last year's Northern and Midland Drivers Champion, comes up to take the final again this year. And 250 has a look at 180, but it's 180 takes the checker. Looking for second, blue top 161 with 354, 172, number 50. So 250 left stranded. Led the final for a long way. Spun out on the last lap. Race brought to an end with the red flag. T So, grand final winner, 180 Ray Witts, fighting to hold on to his Northern Midland Drivers Championship. And a look down the points so far says that 161 Mark Eaton is in the lead. Grand final winner, 180 Ray Witts on the car with him, 161 in second, 354 Richard Ainsworth in third. So we move on now to day two at Hennesford, with Mark Eaton leading the points, Richard Ainsworth in second, Ray Witts in third, then it's 172, number 50, and 250 and 69.
Attacking the illusion by the stopping Jersey man.